Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today the 21st of February, Holy Mother the Church calls us to the memory of Saint Peter Damian. Peter Onesti, the youngest of many children in the poor but noble Ravenna family, was orphaned at the early age and sent to tend swines by one of his brothers. But his piety and intellectual capacities prompted another of his brother, the archpriest Damian of Ravenna, to pay his education. Peter, in gratitude towards his brother Damian of Ravenna, took the name Damian, and therefore he came to be known as Peter Damian. Peter Damian found life in these universities where he went to study so worldly and distracted that he became a hermit monk in Benedictine establishment of Forte Avellana in the Apennines. Peter was particularly devoted to Our Lady. At the age of 36, he became abbot of Forte Avellana and remained so until his death 29 years from then. As such, he wisely moderated the rule, established the regular rule of the discipline together with his friend. His friend was Hildebrand, who would later be Pope Gregory the Seventh, the Great. Pope Gregory the Seventh is known in the church as a reformer, as a great reformer. And Hildebrand, when he was, that is before he could change his name, before he could become a pope, he was a very good friend of the saint of today, Peter Damian. And Peter Damian is known for his very, very terrible indictment of the clergy, the Liber Gomarhaiensis, published in 1051, and the Liber Gratissimus, which concerned itself with the validity of simonical ordinations. In 1057, Pope Stephen X made him Cardinal Bishop of Ostia, which he reluctantly accepted under pain of excommunication, besides being administrator of the Diocese of Gubbio. Peter served seven successive popes and remarkably well on various delicate missions as papal legate and visitor of bishoprics and abbeys. When returning to Rome from one such assignment in the Archdiocese of Ravenna, Peter fell critically ill and died on 22nd February 1072. He was buried in the Cathedral of Faenza and, though never formally canonized, was declared a doctor of the church in 1028. Saint Peter Damian is invoked against headaches because of his having suffered greatly from the malady himself. Peter Damian, someone who was orphaned at a very young age, sent to work by one brother, educated by another brother, went on to become a monk, then a bishop, a cardinal, and he served the church under 6-7 popes, and each pope is so grateful to him for the service that he did. He saved the church from lot of trouble many a times. What great works God can do with us, we do not know. The only thing we have to do is to be available to Him. There was one instance when He did not want to become a bishop, the cardinal in charge of the place. But the bishop had to warn him, and then through a certain warnings he had to make him the bishop of that place. So even when we are not willing sometimes to be in places, the Lord will chisel, mold the situations in a way that He will utilize us. So let us not leave God, but give ourselves completely to Him. Amen.